Good morning, children. Welcome to the second video of the Lake Isle of Innisfree, written by William Butler Yeats, who is considered the greatest Irish poet ever. Now we come to stanza 2, which says, "I will have some peace there, where peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of the morning to where the cricket sings." Basically, the poets want to say that he will have some peace in Innisfree. That's the basic purpose of going to Innisfree. What he expects from Innisfree. First stanza was about his plan. What does he plan to do in Innisfree? It was to settle down there by building a house, planting bean rows, providing bees a hive, and live in an open area. Now, the second stanza talks about his expectations from Innisfree. The first expectation is he would have peace in Innisfree. And he feels peace there comes peacefully. Peace comes dropping slow. Even peace arrives there peacefully. Peace is not in a hurry. It's so peaceful. We call it hyperbole. Extremely peaceful. And where would the peace come from? Peaceful will start from the morning. Right from early morning when the smog covers the area. He refers to them as veils of the morning. And that mist and smog is referred to as the waves of the morning, and that would bring peace to him. And until how long would that peace last? Till the cricket starts chirping. It means when it's late and dark, it will stay peaceful. The midnight saw a glimmer, and noon a purple glow, and evening full of linnet's wings. He feels that at midnight, the sun shines from the moonlight. The sky shines from the moonlight and the stars. The persona can see a glimmer of light on the far shore. The persona can feel the peacefulness in the afternoon when the sun shines brightly. The shines from the sun look purple, soft, not bothering. The persona can also feel the peacefulness in the evening when he can hear the sound of the birds. So basically, peace, although has been divided into different time zones of a day, but they have been given artistic imagery produced about different time. Morning full of mist, the night which is not dark but has a glimmer across the shore. Noon is not harsh with sun baking down, but it's like soft purple glow. And spending the evening among birds sound even more peaceful. Now we start with the final stanza, which says, "I will arise and go now, for always night and day I hear the lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore." The persona will get up and go to Innisfree. He's back again to his room where he's sitting and was planning to go. Now he gives you, first was his plan, second was his expectation, and third is the reason for leaving the city. He says he would go because throughout the night and day he is disturbed by the sound of lake water lapping by the shore of Innisfree. Disturbed in a sense that it makes him realize how peaceful he could choose to be living in Innisfree compared to where he has now settled down. Hence, the poet seems to have made up his mind that he has had enough of the city and he finally wants to settle in Innisfree. Now the final two verses, "While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement grey, I hear it in the deep heart score." So he says, wherever he stands on the roadway, which are crowded, noisy, with cars honking and polluting, and pavements grey, which are dirty, filth, pollution, across the pavements, he wants to leave all that. And because while he stands there, he misses Innisfree. He remembers the lake water, the sound of the lake water. And the sounds originate from the deepest part of his heart. His feelings for Innisfree is very strong. Now let's talk about the subject of the poem. The subject of the poem is beautiful Lake Isle of Innisfree. The place is a sanctuary where one can escape from the hustle and bustle of city life. "And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, So these lines actually are evidence of the fact that it is very peaceful and totally different from the hustling bustling life of a city. So I will thank you to join this video. I will come back again with the third part of this poem in my next video. Till then, all of you stay home, stay safe, and keep studying hard. Goodbye.